It's 3 a.m. Had you on my mind. It's not the first time we've gone through this. Wanting you more and more. I can't help but think of what we could be.
Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today I have a get ready with me for you. I have a video basically showing you me getting ready for something. I show you guys my hair, my makeup, and my outfit. I know you guys love get ready with me's, so be sure to subscribe and turn on post notifications by clicking the bell. Also, like this video and comment down below if you want to see more get ready with me videos this summer. And I'm not gonna ramble, let's just get straight into getting ready together. Let's go. Okay guys, so the first thing that I'm doing in this get ready with me process is of course tying my hair up and putting it out of my face. And sorry, but I'm using my Minnie Mouse headbands. I get so much criticism on this, but it keeps my hair out of my face. Because the weather in the UK had been so generous this week, I decided to put on some SPF onto my face from the Body Shop. This is the Body Shop Vitamin E SPF 30, I believe, and I love this because it's really lightweight, and for someone that gets clogged skin really easily, as you guys know, I have acne prone skin, so SPFs can really clog up my skin, but I really love this one. So I moisturized my face using that, and then I went on top of that for a moisturizing primer using the Glam Glow Starter in the golden shade, and I'm actually using this color corrector from YSL, and I really like this. Again, it's really lightweight, it doesn't feel too thick, so this is great if you want to tone down redness but you don't want it to be overly thick. So I just applied that on my skin and used a duo fiber brush from NYX to blend that in, and as you can see, it's really taken down those redness. For my foundation, I am taking the NYX Total Control foundation, and this is super thick. I always forget how, no, it's not thick, it's thin, but it's full coverage. I always forget how full coverage this is. So I did put on a little bit too much, but it blended in just fine. And I do have a tan right now because I've been out in the sun, so I used a darker shade than normal, but I used my normal light concealer and everything blended in great, which is fabulous. I used this concealer from Maybelline. I haven't used the Age Rewind concealer in ages, and it was like revisiting like an old friend. It was like, ah, familiar. So I just blended that in with my fingers, and then I went in to set it as well afterwards. I used the Soap and Glory Instant Retouch Powder. As you guys know, this is definitely, again, one of my favorites, but I haven't actually used it in a little while, so it was really nice to revisit it and to use one of my like holy grail products. So I set my whole face with this, and then I used a Studio Fix powder from MAC in a darker shade. This is in the shade C8, and I'm using this as my bronzer. I find I love to do this, especially when I have acne on my cheeks, because I just find that it looks a lot smoother, because just the placement of my acne just makes bronzer apply patchier. But I find that using a darker shade of powder makes it look a lot smoother. So this just really helps with my texture. Even though it's improving a lot, it just looks a lot smoother. And then I take a slightly smaller brush and just use that in more concentrated areas, kind of to contour a little bit, but it is quite warm, so I'm not going for anything too like overly sculpted. I'm just using it in those areas. And then I'm taking a highlight shade from this highlight and contour palette and just using it on all of the highlight areas, such as under my eyes, and I also use this to contour my nose as well. I then went in with highlight, and this is the Mocky highlight from NYX, and this is a really interesting texture. I use this on the tops of my cheekbones, and I kind of have to apply this with my fingers a little bit as well. We'll kind of just use my fingers to kind of press it into the skin, because I find that it makes it look more skin-like, but it's a really beautiful texture and really natural looking if you press it into the skin. So I applied that on the tops of my cheekbones, and such a gorgeous color, like blinding but a really nice tone. Then I went in with this Too Faced palette, and I believe it's one of the peach palettes, I can't remember the name of it, but I'll have it written down below. And I'm just using this to create my eye look, and I went for something super simple. I applied some of the peach color all over my eyes and then some bronzer into my crease. I'm kind of taking the bronzer a little bit higher than normal, which is why I applied the lid color first. And I don't know, I just like using this technique because I find that it really, I don't know, just it kind of sculpts the eye slightly different. But yeah, what I did wasn't anything too crazy. For this look, I really wanted it to look peach and spring-like, like almost with a bit of a pinky tone, but nothing too crazy. I also took one of the lighter shades from that palette and just used that on the very inner corner of my eye to really make that inner corner pop, and I love the way this looks. I love using this technique, especially in the spring and summer, because I just find that, I don't know, it just creates that really nice open-eyed look. And then I took this shade from the Naked Heat Petite palette, and then I applied that in the outer corner just to add a little bit of warmth, but also just to add a little bit more definition, just because that bronzer just wasn't enough to really define the crease. I next applied some eyeliner, and this is the NYX Epic Ink eyeliner, and I'm just using it to create a nice big wing. I kind of vary between liking a wing or not, but I really wanted one for this look because I just find that, I don't know, whenever I'm going anywhere, I just like to wear a wing unless I'm not really doing all that much. Then I applied mascara and my false lashes. These are from the House of Lashes Faux Mink collection, and I applied these, and they're actually really, really natural looking. You can't really see them all that much. And I did do my eyebrows, but I'm gonna link an eyebrow tutorial down below because you guys have already seen me do it very recently. I then applied my lipstick. I did my lip liner, which is Rimmel Cappuccino, as per usual. If I'm gonna wear a nude, I'm 99% of the time gonna be using this lip liner. And then I combined two liquid lipsticks to create this really pretty pink peach nude. And I really, really like it. I think it kind of just like complements everything. Okay, so now that my makeup is done, I need to move on to my hair, and this just isn't cutting it, so I am going to actually go and wash my hair and have it curly. And today I'm going to be using the Maui Moisture Curl Quench Coconut Oil Shampoo and Conditioner to wash my hair. You guys, I have 125,000%. Is that a number? Nope. I have definitely found my new shampoo and conditioner that I'm going to be using on the regular, and this is the reason why. So Maui Moisture actually has 5 different ranges for different hair types, but I am using the one specifically for curly hair. So their products actually have no mineral oil, no silicones, no SLS, no sulfates, and just a bunch of other bad stuff that is definitely not in it, and I'm obsessed with it. It's vegan as well, and it also has pure coconut water and pure aloe juice in it. And you guys, it is a dream. It smells insane. It's super natural. So the product that I'm using right now is the Curl Quench Coconut Oil Curl Smoothie, and I'm applying this in my hair as I diffuse it, just to really help with the curls to, you know, like help form and hydrate them. And plus, something to bear in mind as well is this is the first time I've had my hair curly since I got it lightened, and as you can imagine, I got it from a fairly deep shade of brunette to as blonde as it is right now, so my hair is definitely feeling dry, but these products really, really helped with that. You can definitely feel the coconut oil without it being too overly heavy, and that's something that's really important with curly hair. You can't have too much oil in your hair at once, otherwise it can weigh down the curls, so I felt like this was just enough to really hydrate my curls. I did recently do a curly hair video, and I mentioned that I hadn't had a silicone-free shampoo or conditioner that I loved, and I was actually asking you guys for suggestions, and now I have found Maui Moisture, and I'm so happy. I was also looking for a sulfate-free shampoo and conditioner, and I'm just so happy that I found them. Plus, it smells insane, you guys. It smells as good as you'd imagine, because obviously it has the rich coconut oil, papaya butter, it also has the aloe vera within it as well, and it just smells insane. So despite my hair being in probably one of the worst conditions that they've been in a while, because of me lightening my hair, this product really, really helped with that. And as you can see, the curls are still forming. I am still obviously learning how to take care of my hair whilst it is blonde and curly, but these products really worked well in my hair. There were still parts of my hair that wouldn't quite form a curl properly, and I used to have this problem before when my hair was blonde, and that's literally just because bleach really can straighten the curls and really damage them. But honestly, I'm so impressed with the way that this range really helped with my hair, considering the condition that my hair was in. So hydrating, and I just love the fact that it allows you to have that, I guess, coconut oil feel without it feeling oily, and with it still feeling hydrating. It honestly felt so lightweight, but really hydrating at the same time, which I love. So as you can see, I've kind of just blow dried my hair with using minimal heat though. I use the cool setting on my blow dryer because I don't want it to obviously affect my hair too much. Yeah, you can see that the ends of my hair are still kind of struggling to form curls, but that's of course because of the bleach. But I'm obsessed with the way that this turned out, and these products are amazing. I'll be leaving links down below if you want to check them out. They're super inexpensive. They're only around $8.99 each, so that's insane. So I'll leave a link to those down below and you can get them from Boots. And now we're going to move on to the outfit. So for my outfit, because I was just going for something rather casual, but the weather was up and down. It actually rained this day, but it was really warm. So I went for these ripped jeans, and these are from Miss Pat. These are of course really, really ripped, but they're really nice fit and I like the way that they fit on my body. And I paired that with a belt from ASOS. My bandeau top is from Pretty Little Thing, and then the jacket that I have draped over me is from the Misguided and Medicine Beer collection. I also paired that with some high top Vans and then some socks from Adidas, just to add a little bit of that Layla vibe through it. You know, if something ever looks too girly, I have to add on some kind of trainers and then some kind of sporty jacket. I'm honestly just I'm just not capable of being totally girly, honestly. So guys, that is the end of this video. I really hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Like I said, all links will be down below to the Maui Moisture products and also to the clothing items, and I will have listed all of the makeup products that I used as well. But that is it from me today, guys. I love you all so much and I will see you all in the next one. Bye guys. Baby, I want to see you. Baby, now it's your life.